Hello and greetings from Iceland. This volcano update is a bit different since I got lucky when I found an excellent science debate about the earthquakes in West Iceland. And a good science debate is of course Christmas time for armchair experts that get the chance to listen to the arguments and pick sides. So it's time to place our bets, since this is a very public debate between two respected experts. And the debate alone provides information and speculations regarding the growing seismic activity by the lake Grjótárvatn in West Iceland. And it so happens that I recently processed footage from my last drone trip there. So this debate is, of course, a good excuse to put on a little show. And this story starts in the spring of 2021 with frequent earthquakes by the lake, where earthquakes had previously been very rare, and this unusual activity continued for the next few years and increased significantly in August 2024. And experts seem to agree on that this is caused by magma movements. And the ongoing science debate is about how likely it is that this will develop into a volcanic eruption within the next 3 years. And while I will be talking about what we know and don't know, I'm going to show you the landscape around there, starting with the big picture. And this is the Reykjanes Peninsula. And north of it, we have the Snæfellsnes Peninsula. And although it looks pretty much the same from up here, those volcanic systems differ in several key ways. Like Reykjanes is the naughty youngster, the unpredictable, unreliable and undeveloped prankster, totally out of control, and not mature enough to come up with something else than basalt, which is of course quite dull in the long run, especially for full-time armchair experts. And the Snæfellsnes Peninsula, it has more diverse features. The landscape includes more evolved rocks, like rhyolite. Volcanism there is older, with long periods of dormancy, and not limited to the very common shield volcanoes like we see on the Reykjanes Peninsula. The most famous volcano there is the ancient stratovolcano Snæfellsjökull, partially hidden under a glacier. And it's such a legend that I made a video about it a few years back and linking to it, because it is the volcano that inspired Jules Verne to write the novel The Journey to the Center of the Earth. And Snæfellsjökull is in fact only one of three systems there. The next system is on the middle of the peninsula, around 30 kilometers long, and it has been dormant for a long time. And it's the third system that is our main topic. It is quite large. The western part of it is on the actual peninsula, and it's 90 kilometers long, so a large part of it stretches all the way into the Borgarfjörður district. And for the untrained eye, this looks like two systems, with the valley Hnappadalur in between. So this is roughly the system outlined, and I will be using this map to show you where the drone is at any given time while I talk about this dispute. And if I start with what experts seem to agree on, it's that they don't expect a major eruption. They seem to expect something like this spot that I'm flying over here, or this lava field that looks as it's coming from out of nowhere. And that is what makes this landscape so special. Fertile farmlands all around, and then something like this. So I love the contrasts around here, and I could spend days filming those formations to do them justice. And some are larger than others, like this crater, Eldborg, that is very impressive. So this is nothing like the Reykjanes Peninsula. That is this one chunk of lava in many layers. And scientists expect that if this will develop all the way into a volcanic eruption, we will just get one more lava field there, not so big. So that is what they expect, judging from history. And this ongoing debate is about where this is taking us. And the professor that has been stirring things up is Þorvaldur Þórarason. And just recently, he was saying that the magma, which scientists seem to agree that exists at a depth of 20 kilometers, is moving upwards. And he is basing his view on new studies on the volcanic formations on the Snæfellsnes Peninsula. So Professor Þorvaldur is actually saying that we could expect a volcanic eruption here sooner than later. And like to expect, the Icelandic media picked up his announcement that got a good coverage. And the Icelandic media actually loves to have Professor Þorvaldur around because he's always a good source of discussion. But he has also been met with criticism for lacking evidence, although he tends to get some of his long shots right. And often it's long shots where others didn't dare to try. So the media and Icelanders, we tend to forgive him when he is not spot on. Or just as long as he continues to talk about volcanology openly and allows us to speculate with him. But this statement that we could be moving closer to a volcanic eruption in West Iceland received harsh criticism this time, mainly from a scientist that has actually retired officially. And I'm talking about Haraldur Sigurðsson. He's one of our leading volcanologists with a very impressive career. But after he retired, he returned to his hometown where he operated a geology museum for years. And he is still very active in general discussions about the ongoing events like on the Reykjanes Peninsula and elsewhere. And I often read his articles on Facebook. And it was actually Haraldur that came up with a formula during the 2014 Bárðarbunga eruption, where he predicted the end of that eruption with excellent accuracy, which was impressing because it was a long shot. So it was a bit of a surprise when Haraldur came out with his statement that Þorvaldur had no data supporting his theory about how soon this might develop into a volcanic eruption. And Professor Þorvaldur did reply through the media. He was obviously surprised to see his fellow volcanologist reply in this way. And then the Met Office joined the party, actually backing up Haraldur, saying that we don't see magma moving upwards and it's too early for a shout out about a volcanic eruption in the next 3 years. However, we can all see with the available online tools that a lot of the earthquakes now are taking place at 15 to 20 kilometers depth and also at the less depth. But we can also see them at 20 kilometers depth and even deeper. So this dispute more and less boils down to data interpretation. And I've been seeing it in the media discussion that experts have been asking for more equipment there to increase the accuracy since the seismometer network there is not very dense. And even though it's the official role of the Met Office to oversee all instruments, they do not have the full trust of the media as for data interpretation, which explains why the media is constantly picking up other phone numbers, calling other scientists, because that method has turned out well for them. And even the media has been criticized for that approach. But again, it has proven to be the right approach to keep this open, not limit the discussion to only few scientists. And I agree, of course. I think the media here has done a good job, and I'm very sure that the local farmers in West Iceland, they agree too, when I'm saying that we need to keep all views on the table. And so public friction between volcanologists here in Iceland is actually quite rare, to the best of my knowledge, at least on the surface. And both those scientists have one thing in common. They have not been afraid to come out with statements. And since I'm an Icelander, knowing a bit about Icelandic characteristics, I suspect that this dispute is about a bit more than science alone. And geology and volcanology, it isn't like math where things add up. And for me, it is this lack of understanding that makes this such a fun subject, and even more fun when we have scientists nearby that are willing and able to explain what can be explained. And best of all is when they make a go for the questions that cannot be explained. And after this upload, I'm getting ready to move on the road again for the longer trips. But like always, this is Iceland. I'm just following the light, and that is a concept that works very nicely for me. Not to know where I will be tomorrow. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.